Hey, what's up? It's Cody. Welcome back to the channel. Now today, I'm gonna show you how to mix pro vocals in just four simple steps. We're gonna take them from sounding like this.
In my head.
To sounding like this.
I couldn't hear anything you said, but.
Now you don't need to be a mixing wizard or have recorded on really great gear to do this. Literally anybody can do it with just four simple tools that you should already have. And I'm gonna show you exactly what you need and how to do it. So let's jump right into it. As always, if you do find a video like this helpful, if you could do me a huge favor and please just drop a like down below. It seriously helps out my channel and this video gets seen by many more people. So thank you so much in advance if you do that. All right, let's jump into it. All right, so if you look at my vocal chain here, it may seem like there's a lot going on, but really there isn't. There's not a whole lot. It's four simple things. If you break it all down, I just have them layered. So let's jump in right to the first one and show you exactly what it is. Now, the first thing that I'm doing is I'm tuning the vocal. Now, I know there's a lot of controversy about tuning vocals, but let me tell you, if you're working on any kind of pop song or a rock song or anything that's like mainstream or radio ready, you're gonna need to tune your vocals. Bottom line, that's just how it goes. I know a lot of people are against it and say that it's cheating, but let me tell you, literally everybody is tuning their vocals. Now, tuning doesn't mean we're making it sound like T-Pain or anything. It's pitch correction at the end of the day. We're just helping the notes get to where they need to be. Now, this was a very well-sung vocal, and it doesn't need to be tuned by any means, but if you want that polish and you want your vocal to sound great, you're gonna need to tune it. So what I'm using here is Waves Tune Real Time. I love the plugin. It sounds really good. It's kind of hard to overdo it and get that really steppy sound like T-Pain. So I love it. It's so easy. I throw it on and I don't really have to make too many adjustments as long as it's a pretty well sung vocal. If the vocal's horribly out of tune, this isn't really gonna help. You're gonna have to go in and do something by hand. But I have a well sung vocal by a good singer. So let's hear just what this plugin is doing. Let's listen to the vocal soloed without it.
In my head, I couldn't hear anything you said, but
vocal's pretty well in tune, but let's just throw it on and hear the difference.
In my head, I couldn't hear anything you said, but
that's great. It just tightens everything up and makes it perfectly in tune. Not even perfectly in tune, but just better. It helps bump up the flat notes and bring down the sharp notes a little bit. And it just kind of overall gives us that polish that we're looking for right off the bat. So step number one is tune your vocals. It's really gonna make a big difference. All right, the second thing I got pulled up here is an EQ. Now, this might look like quite a daunting thing going on. Look at all these cuts and stuff, but really it's not that crazy. I just happened to make all of these different cuts and be very precise with it, but you don't have to be. Basically, all that's going on here is just this. All I'm doing here is I'm pulling out a little bit of that low end, the mud as it's called, and a little bit of that telephone or nasally sound that I wasn't really liking with it. Now, this vocal, I wasn't able to be part of the recording process, unfortunately, and it was just recorded on a Shure SM58. I'm sure you've seen one of these microphones before. They're kind of all over the place, whether you played a live show or even maybe you've used one in studio or you have one laying around. So these are really great microphones, and like I said, you don't need anything too fancy. This is gonna do the trick if you're just doing demos or even working on a final product, but you need to know some things about it. Listening to it, I can hear there's a lot of low end, so that's why I made this major cut down here, is just because this microphone has a big proximity effect, meaning the closer you get a lot of that low boominess. So I just took some of that out that I heard. And then up here, there was some weird stuff going on. I don't know if it was the singer in particular or whether it was the room that he was in. All I did was just take him out and it helps. It's still kind of there. You're never gonna get rid of that room sound or any of those artifacts entirely, but this is gonna help. Now, if you are new to recording vocals and not just mixing, but actually recording them themselves, I did a video a couple weeks ago on some steps to help improve the way you record your vocals, getting it into the computer. So I'll drop a link down below. Be sure to go check that one out right after this because you're not gonna be able to mix a vocal if it's not recorded well. So most important thing is record a good vocal and then you're gonna refine it and polish it with the mix. All right, so let's listen to exactly what this EQ is doing to our vocal. Listen to it bypassed.
In my head, I couldn't hear anything you said, but.
And then with it on.
In my head, I couldn't hear anything you said, but.
So it's just, I'm still holding this microphone. So it's just giving us a little bit of clarity and really opening up the vocal and giving us that detail that we need so that we can hear all the pronunciation of the words and taking out a lot of that mud that's just gonna get in the way. I also have this roll off at 80 because we don't need any of the low end in the vocal. It's just gonna give us a bunch of unwanted noise at the end of the day. All right, so we've kind of done all the refining and getting our vocal to a starting ground. We've tuned it to help get it perfectly in pitch, and then we've made our vocal flat by EQing out any of the buildup frequencies or unwanted things that shouldn't really be there in the first place. So from here, what I like to do is I like to de-ess it. I really like a bright pop vocal with a lot of top end, a lot of that sizzle to it, right? So when you do that, what often ends up happening is you get a lot of S sounds and a lot of sibilance, and they come through and they just destroy your mix. So I pulled up a de-esser here. I happen to be using the Waves Sibilance de-esser. It has this really great bright pop preset that I use. I basically just pull up this preset and don't change anything. Every once in a while I will, but it's a really great sounding plugin. Would recommend it. However, you don't need a plugin like this. Pretty much every DAW has a built-in de-esser. Pro Tools has one that I'm actually using later on, but we'll get to that in a minute. Logic has one, Ableton has one, they all have them. So just use whatever you got. And all we're trying to do with this is just take down those S's. So let me show you before and after what this plugin is doing.
In my head, I couldn't hear anything you said, but...
So you hear a lot of those S's coming through on couldn't hear anything you said, but... So let's turn this on and hear what it does.
I couldn't hear anything you said, but...
And then off.
I couldn't hear anything you said, but...
On.
I couldn't hear anything you said, but...
So all this plugin is doing is really just help taming the top end. It's bringing down the S's on said and a little bit on that couldn't. There was a bit of a high frequency noise there. And it just helps, like I said, try to flatten out the vocal and make sure that there's nothing that sticks out and is gonna get in the way. All right, from here, the next thing I did was I pulled up this C6 plugin from Waves. I absolutely love this plugin. It's just a multiband compressor. If you don't know what multiband compression is, basically is it's kind of combines an EQ and a compressor into one. So you're only gonna compress certain frequencies of the spectrum. I could do a whole video on exactly what multiband compression is, but I'll leave that for another day. Basically what I did with this is there's this really great preset. Again, I love presets, I'm all about them, which is called Pooch Vocal. It's a Ken Pooch preset. He's a really good live engineer, and I just love what it does to the voice. I don't use it all the time, but every once in a while, I'll just throw it on as a starting point, and sometimes it does most of the work without me having to do anything. So I threw it on, and I guess I liked it, and it made it to the very end. So let's hear what this plugin's doing.
In my head, I couldn't hear anything you said, but... In my head, I couldn't hear anything you said, but...
So what this plugin is really doing is just kind of help leveling out all the sound. When there's a little too much buildup in the low end, it's gonna duck it down. And when there's a little too much buildup in the top end or a lot of those S's start poking through again, it's gonna just duck them down only when that frequency is present. All right, I'm gonna count that last one as kind of a bonus step. Here is the actual step 4, and it is just a compressor. What you're doing with the compressor is you're help leveling it out. You're taking everything that's too loud and ducking it back down, and it's gonna help give us a more even vocal throughout. We're gonna have to do less automation work, and it's just gonna kind of help it sit better in the mix without there being any words or phrases that are popping out and standing out from the rest of the song. So what I actually did here is I stacked two of these compressors on top of each other. You'll notice I have one coming in with a pretty fast attack and release time, and then one with a much slower attack. So this vocal was recorded without any compression going into it. It's just a raw vocal. So I need to do quite a bit of work. It's quite a dynamic vocal, and I wanna cut a lot of the dynamics and keep it pretty level throughout. So you'll notice this first one has a pretty fast attack, and basically my goal with it is every time it gets a little too loud, I wanna just cut it down and bring it down to an equal level to the rest of the song. And then the second compressor has a slower attack. So as that first one catches and starts to release, I want the second one to come in and just kind of help balance it out. So I don't need it to be working as fast. And you'll notice I actually ended up going with a pretty high ratio here, which I don't normally do, but it's just what sounded the best in this situation. So I will bypass these plugins on and off and show you exactly what they're doing.
In my head, I couldn't hear anything you said, but in my head.
So these are pretty heavily compressed vocals. You'll notice it starts to get a little bit squashed, but that's okay. That's the sound I'm going for. I really want this vocal to not have those peaks in it, and I want it to sit in your face. I want you to know that this vocal is the main part of the song, and I really want it to just pop. So by compressing a vocal heavily like this, it really helps get the consistency out of it and tame all the parts that are too loud and give you that polish that you need to make it a mix-ready song. Okay, so I said I got 4 tips for you. I've kind of covered 5. The Wave C6 was a bonus one, but you'll still notice I have 2 more plugins here. And all that it is I have another EQ, which was tip 2, and another de-esser, which was tip 3. So the first EQ we used was a little bit more of a surgical precision EQ. This was to get rid of any unwanted frequencies and just kind of give us a flat vocal to go into our compressor and to help tame everything that we didn't really want there. Now this next one is where we're gonna add the flavor to the vocal. So let's give it a listen and hear exactly what this compressor is doing. Sorry, not compressor, it's an EQ. I lied. Let's see what this EQ is doing.
In my head, I couldn't hear anything you said, but in my head, I couldn't hear anything you said, but.
So you'll notice it's actually pretty subtle in what it's doing. I am doing some like decent moves here. We're doing 4 dB at like 13K, and then we're bringing in a little bit of that 5K again. I'm cutting out a bit of that 600 and giving us a little bit of 240. Now, one of the things is I did give it a lot of this top end, that 13K and then even some 5K here. And you'll notice the S's really start coming back. Give it a listen.
In my head, I couldn't hear anything you said, but.
So I used another de-esser. I didn't use the same one as last time because you can't really change the frequency, and I feel like it was only getting the top end of the frequencies, like 8, 9K above. So I opted to go for the stock Pro Tools one because it sounds really great and all plugins will do the same thing at the end of the day, and it really doesn't matter which one you have. So let me show you what this plugin's doing here. Without it.
In my head, I couldn't hear anything you said, but.
So mainly on that said, listen to it without.
And you said, but.
And then with.
And you said, but, in my head.
So it's really just helping to tame the top end of the vocal, and really it just helps us give us a more presentable sound and makes it sound better along the way. So I know it seems like there's a lot going on here, but really if you break it down, it's only 4 things. All you need to do is tune your vocal, EQ it, de-ess it, and compress it. So yeah, these are all things that you can do to help make your vocals sit in your mix a little bit better and really give you a professional polished sound. Now, there are other things you can do as well, like adding reverbs and delays and stereo wideners, and these are all very, very important things, but I just wanted to focus on what exactly to do to the vocal itself, just with the basic tools, not getting into any crazy effects, just to help it sound a little bit better. Now, if you do want me to expand on this and show you what kind of reverbs and delays and stuff that I use on a vocal and what I'm using in this song in particular, let me know. Drop a comment down below and I'd love to do a video on that and a little bit more in depth of exactly what I'm doing when it comes to mixing a vocal. Just before I wrap up here, I'll play you this section of the song one more time with the plugins bypassed and then with them on, just to show you exactly what we're doing with the vocal to make it pop a little bit. But anyways, thank you so much for watching, and as always, don't forget to drop a like down below if you found this video helpful. Share it with your friends or anybody else who might be mixing any music, whether it's yours or their own, and could use some help with some vocals, and then don't forget to subscribe so that you don't miss out on any more of my videos. Let me play you out with this one. Enjoy. Thanks for being here.